In this video, I will talk about some project network concepts, early event time, late event time, total float, and critical path. Early event time and late event time are associated with nodes in the network. Early event time of node I is denoted by ETI. It is the earliest time at which the event corresponding to node I can occur. Late event time for node I is denoted by LTI. It is the latest time at which the event corresponding to node I can occur without delaying the completion of the project. Let's check some examples. This is a part of a project network. Activities A, B, and C. Their durations are 4 days, 5 days, and 3 days, respectively. Activities A and B are predecessors of activity C. Suppose we know the early event times for nodes 2 and 3. They are 8 and 6, respectively. Let's find the early event time for nodes 4 and 5. The earliest time node 2 can happen is at time 8. The duration of activity A is 4. So the earliest time node 4 can happen is 8 plus 4 is equal to 12. The earliest time node 3 can happen is at time 6. The duration of activity B is 5. So the earliest time node 4 can happen is 6 plus 5 is equal to 11. So we have two options. We need to determine which one to choose. We know that node 4 can happen only if both activities A and B are finished. At time 11, although activity B is finished, activity A is still not finished. So we need to pick the larger number. Therefore, the early event time of node 4 should be 12. Now, the earliest time node 4 can happen is at time 12. The duration of activity C is 3. So the earliest time node 5 can happen is 12 plus 3 is equal to 15. This is a part of another project network. Activities A, B, and C. Their durations are 4 days, 5 days, and 3 days, respectively. Activities B and C are successors of activity A. Suppose we know the late event times for nodes 4 and 5, they are 13 and 10, respectively. Let's find the late event time for nodes 3 and 2. The latest time node 4 can happen is at time 13. The duration of activity B is 5. So the latest time node 3 can happen is 13 minus 5 is equal to 8. The latest time node 5 can happen is at time 10. The duration of activity C is 3. So the latest time node 3 can happen is 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. So we have two options. We need to determine which one to choose. We know that both activities B and C can start only if node 3 happened. If node 3 happens at time 8, although activity B can be finished while not changing the late time of node 4, activity C is still not finished at time 10 because 8 plus 3 is equal to 11. So we need to pick the smaller number. Therefore, the late event time of node 3 should be 7. Now the latest time node 3 can happen is at time 7. The duration of activity A is 4. So the latest time node 2 can happen is 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. After we are clear with the two special cases, let's check the house building project network introduced in a previous video. Assume that we know the early time of node 1 is 0. That is the start time of the entire project. For node 2, the early time is equal to the early time of node 1 plus the duration of activity B. It is equal to 9. For node 3, the early time has two options. We need to calculate the early time of node 1 plus the duration of activity A, and it is equal to 6. Then we need to calculate the early time of node 2 plus the duration of the dummy activity, and it is equal to 9. We need to pick the larger value 9 as the early time for node 3. For note 4, the early time is equal to the early time of note 3 plus the duration of activity C. It is equal to 16. For note 5, the early time has two options. We need to calculate the early time of note 3 plus the duration of activity D, and it is equal to 17. Then we need to calculate the early time of note 4 plus the duration of activity E, and it is equal to 26. We need to pick the larger value, 26, as the early time for note 5. For note 6, the early time is equal to the early time of note 5 plus the duration of activity F. It is equal to 38. As a general rule, we can think of the early time of node I as the length of the longest path in the project network from node 1 to node I. For example, from node 1 to node 3, the longest path is 1, 2, 3, and the length is 9. From node 1 to node 5, the longest path is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the length is 26. Now assume that we know the late time of node 6 is 38. It is the end time of the entire project. For node 5, the late time is equal to the late time of node 6 minus the duration of activity F. It is equal to 26. For node 4, the late time is equal to the late time of node 5 minus the duration of activity E. It is equal to 16. For node 3, the late time has two options. We need to calculate the late time of node 4 minus the duration of activity C, and it is equal to 9. Then we need to calculate the late time of node 5 minus the duration of activity D, and it is equal to 18. We need to pick the smaller value, 9, as the late time of node 3. For node 2, the late time is equal to the late time of node 3 minus the duration of the dummy activity. It is equal to 9. For node 1, the late time has two options. We need to calculate the late time of node 3 minus the duration of activity A, and it is equal to 3. Then we need to calculate the late time of node 2 minus the duration of activity B, and it is equal to 0. We need to pick the smaller value 0 as the late time for node 1. As a general rule, the late time of node I is equal to the late time of the end node minus the length of the longest path from the end node to node I. For example, let's consider node 3. The longest path from the end node to node 3 is 6, 5, 4, 3. The length is 12 plus 10 plus 7 is equal to 29. The late time of the end node 6 is 38. 38 minus 29 is equal to 9, which is the late time of node 3. Here is a summary of the early time and late time for all the nodes. We find that for each node, the early time is equal to the late time. That means any delay in the occurrence of node I will delay the completion of the project. Now I'll introduce another concept called total float. The total float of an activity is the amount of time by which the activity can be delayed beyond its earliest possible starting time without delaying the project finishing time. It is a measure of the scheduling flexibility of the activity. It can be calculated using this formula. We use two nodes I, j to represent an arc or activity. The total float of activity from node I to node j is equal to the late time of node j minus the early time of node I and minus the duration of the activity between node I and node j. Let's use the house building example to do the calculation. Activity B is denoted by arc 1, 2. The total float of activity B is equal to the late time of node 2 minus the early time of node 1 minus the duration of activity B. It is equal to 0. Similarly, we can calculate the total float of all other activities. We find that activity A has a total float of 3. Activity D has a total float of 9. And all other activities have a total float of 0. Now I'll introduce another two concepts. Any activity with a total float of zero is called a critical activity. A path from the start node to the completion node that consists entirely of critical activities is called a critical path. If an activity is a critical activity, any delay in the start of the activity will delay the completion of the project. Let's check these concepts graphically using the house building project network. Node 1 represents the event that the project starts at this moment. Following node 1, we can start activities A and B. A lasts for 6 days and B for 9 days. After B is finished, we reach node 2. Then the dummy activity will start. Because the duration is 0, it will finish instantly. And now we reach node 3. After that, activities C and D can start. After C is finished, we reach node 4. Then activity E will start and it will lead us to node 5. Finally, activity F will start and we will reach the completion node of the project. The total float of activity A is 3. It means we have a flexibility of 3 days for this activity. We can delay it for at most 3 days without delaying the project completion time. The total float of activity D is 9. It means we have a flexibility of 9 days for this activity. We can delay it for at most 9 days without delaying the project completion time. For other activities, B, dummy, C, E, and F, the total floats are just 0. They cannot be delayed without delaying the project completion time. They are critical activities. This is the critical path. In a project network, a critical path is a sequence of activities that add up to the longest overall duration. The total length of the path is 38. The critical path determines the shortest possible time to finish the project. In order to find the critical paths in a project network, we can formulate it as a linear programming problem and solve it using the simplex method. We can define xi as the time corresponding to node I. We would like to minimize the duration of the entire project. That means the completion time minus the start time. For each activity ij, we know that before node j occurs, node I must occur, and activity ij must be completed. This implies that xj is greater than or equal to xi plus tij, where tij is the duration of the activity. We can build 7 constraints using this relation. If we do not define the start time, x1, the project can start at any time, and the problem will have an infinite number of optimal solutions. So we add one more constraint and sign restrictions, so x1 starts at time 0. Time corresponding to every other node is greater than or equal to 0. This is a complete problem formulation. Okay, we talked about some project and network concepts like early event time, late event time, total float, and critical paths in this video. Thanks for watching.